Did you know that badass working men have been wearing sweaters for almost 500 years? Seriously, during medieval times in Northern Europe, we saw the first sweaters pop up. The gurdy. This was a sweater that was for the working man, the guy that's going to be out in the elements. He's going to be out on the ocean, and he needs a piece of gear that's actually going to do a good job of keeping him warm, of keeping him insulated from that cold weather. In today's video, gents, the ultimate guide to men's sweaters and how you can look great wearing one. First up, we've got the gurdy. This is the sweater I'm wearing right now. This is a modern interpretation, but even modern interpretations of the gurdy go for a very simple sweater. This sweater is so simple, I could actually wear it either side. So there isn't a back, there isn't a front. And that's the key characteristic of a gurney. This was a very utilitarian piece of gear, something that was sewn for a man that just simply needed to have protection. It was oftentimes handmade at home. So they follow a lot of the tradition. Now, one of the more interesting things here is the crew neck. This is actually a new addition. Older gurneys that you'll see, they actually don't have anything like this. This was added and actually is easily replaced because they understood they wanted something that could fit closer to the neck and actually keep, you know, the elements out of there. At the same time, could be replaced because it would be these areas that would oftentimes get frayed and torn. Next up, we've got the Erin sweater, named for the islands off the west coast of Ireland. Again, an area that's going to be cold, that's going to be wet, and the fishermen there, they needed gear that was going to keep them warm. Now, one of the things that you'll notice with classic sweaters is most of them are made from wool. Wool can absorb about 40% of its weight in water and actually still feel dry. It will still retain heat. Now, the key characteristic that gives away this is an Erin sweater is going to be the cable knitting. You're going to see this on the front of the sweater. Different sweaters coming from different areas are going to have very different knitting, but this is something that actually, if you go back and you look at a lot of clans, a lot of different groups of people would actually identify where you came from based on the knitting. So very interesting, very much, you know, a whole art to this. Now, when it comes to wearing Erin sweaters, understand that these are casual. They're going to be heavier weight. They're great, actually can be worn almost as outerwear if you want something casual to wear around town. They're very durable. These are very heavyweight, warm, tough sweaters, and I think look great with jeans. You could wear them with odd trousers, but it wouldn't be something you would ever wear with a suit. Next up, let's talk about naval sweaters. So I'm wearing here a variation of the Submariner. As the name implies, this was worn by British sailors during World War II on submarines. You also saw other navies pick this up. Why? Because when you're on those vessels and you're under the water, it's cold. And a lot of times, to conserve energy, they kept the temperature and the heating at a very low temperature. It gets cold down there. So you had to be able to have insulation. You also needed something that could get wet. Something that when you're getting up on top of the sub, you get sprayed with water, you would be fine, or at least you would be able to recover from it. The point is that these also needed to be close to the body because you're moving in and around a lot of people. It was, again, a functional piece of gear. Now, you may notice how bulky the sweater is. And this is a very casual sweater. Also, the neck part right here, this is an extreme turtleneck. This is going to keep you warm. This has a functional purpose. But again, everything about this sweater is casual. So it looks great with jeans. You could even dress it up with a pair maybe of gray flannel trousers, but you would not wear this with a suit. Another naval sweater I want to quickly talk about, the woolly pulley. So if you've ever served in the Marine Corps, you know what I'm talking about. That woolly pulley, it was itchy. It was something a lot of guys did not want to wear. But now that I know the history, I understand where it came from. They were made to fit close to the body. They were made to keep you warm when you're in a cold environment and still be able to move around, fit close to the body. They actually had on the elbows and on the shoulders a bit of protection to avoid snags. Next up, we've got the crew neck. This is going to be one of the most common sweaters you see out there. And this one, because of the tightness of the weave, the light build overall of the sweater, this is one that you can layer and you can start to wear under a sports jacket. You can even possibly wear this under a suit if the color and the style work. Now, what is the style of the crew sweater? Again, this is one that actually does have a back, does have a front, so it's different from the gurney in that way. But overall, it's very similar. And what we're going to find is elastic in here around the wrist. We're going to find right here around the neck. And this is where it gets its name. So this was first made popular on ships. Again, why are we going for a crew neck in a working environment? Because you don't want sea spray. You don't want water going down in and around there. So it was meant to be elastic. And they also knew that this would be the area that would break down, that would tear. And so they made it so it could be easily repaired. Now, as if this sweater is so common, you're going to find it in a variety of color, a variety of patterns. If you're buying your first crew neck sweaters, keep it simple. I really like a charcoal gray or a regular gray, maybe even a medium gray. Why do I say gray? Because it's going to pretty much match anything. It's a neutral non-color. Or you could actually maybe go with something that you already wear a lot of. So maybe you want to go with blue. works with what's in your wardrobe. You want to go maybe with a dark red like this. You already know you've got items like this and they'll work with your existing interchangeable wardrobe. The key is don't go for anything that is really bright as your first sweater. Maybe for a Christmas sweater, if you've got a party, okay, that makes sense. But what you want to do is bring in something that's going to work throughout your wardrobe. Now the style, the actual weave, the lighter and the closer it fits to your body, I think that's better. So again, not going to an extreme here, but the point being you want it to fit when you're buying a sweater. And this is key because sweaters are very difficult to adjust. You can take them to someone who can knit and they can actually bring it in. They can adjust the sweater, but it's something that if it's too short, and what I mean by too short, if you raise up your arms and here it actually goes up and we can see your midsection, that's way too short. If you pull the sweater down and it goes about 4 to 5 inches beyond actually what your waist area is, that's pushing it. You don't ever want to pull it down and cover your backside. That's way too long. But usually a sweater is going to have an elastic in and around the waist. And so as long as it can crunch up in and around your midsection and stay about in that area, you're good to go. Next up, let's talk about the V-neck, second in popularity only behind the crew neck. But in my opinion, the V-neck is one of the most versatile sweaters that you can own. And I think men should wear more of these. I like how you can dress them down. So I could actually wear this, you know, with this shirt right here, dark jeans, pair of brogues, great combination. Or I could actually wear this with a white dress shirt, wear it with a casual suit or even a business suit in inclement weather with, you know, black Oxfords, and that would be a fine look. Now right here we've got a bold, strong color, and I think that bold, beautiful colors are great when you own multiple sweaters. But if you're just starting off looking to buy your first V-neck sweater, you want to go gray. You maybe go for a little bit darker than this, or you could even go with a tan or a brown, especially if you've got navy or you've got blue a lot in your wardrobe, especially with your trousers. Right here, this combination, this light tan, is going to look great with that color. Now, because V-neck sweaters are so common, you're going to find they're made from a wide variety of materials out there. Ideally, you want to go with cashmere or you want to go with wool. But I understand that that can be very expensive for a lot of people. So you're going to see blends out there. You're going to see synthetic materials thrown in. You're going to see cotton sweaters. Understand what you're getting. When you go with cotton, you're really losing a lot of the insulating properties. That being said, it is something that could be lightweight. You could actually go for a summer sweater. Yes, there is such a thing as a summer sweater. Or maybe when it's a synthetic material, you understand, okay, I'm compromising here on quality, but I'm going to get this at a great price, and it's got a mix of wool in it. Now, understand, if you see recycled wool, be very careful with that. That's wool that's been used again and again, and the strands basically have become much shorter than they originally were with virgin wool, and so it's not going to be as strong. It's going to be more likely to pill, and that's something you'll see on a lot of your sweaters, is pilling after you've worn them for a while, and that's where basically material starts to build up. Understand you can actually get a depiller. There are machines that you could run over it. You could actually take a depiller stone, or you could even take a razor to get rid of the pilling. Next up, we've got the turtleneck, and you may be wondering what's the difference between the turtleneck and the classic Submariner, the navy sweater. The big thing is going to be the weight of the sweater. Notice how this sweater is not nearly as bulky as the Submariner. So this sweater can be layered. Oftentimes, this sweater is also going to be made not only with a tighter weave, but with higher quality materials. Now, wool is great, but wool, even though it's a luxury material, is not going to be as sought after as cashmere. So cashmere, what this sweater is made from, it's going to be a thinner strand when we actually look at the fiber. It's also going to be one that can be longer and can be sewn into a tighter weave. And what we get is something that actually is going to be warmer than wool, lighter than wool, and is sought after because of its very nice feel. So wool sweaters can be very itchy. Cashmere is not going to have that issue. Again, when you get down, you look at the fiber, you see what the difference is. And it's simply the size of the cashmere fiber is much smaller. Wool oftentimes is going to have barbs, and that's why it actually itches. Now, you can wear a turtleneck by itself, or you can pair it with a sports jacket. You can wear it with a casual suit. And so many guys are going to say, turtlenecks are not my thing. Guys, don't knock it till you try it. Turtlenecks, I think they're absolutely amazing. And if you agree, let me know down in the comments, or you disagree. Tell me how you can't wear a turtleneck. The point is, go out there and try one on, because I think when you wear a great looking turtleneck, one maybe made from cashmere, not only does it feel great, it's functional, it keeps you warm. Right now, it's really cold outside. This outfit is going to be warmer than just wearing a dress shirt, and you stand out from the crowd. Next up, we've got the polo knit sweater. And I just looked at myself in the mirror and I'm wondering, you know, should I actually be wearing two collars next to each other? You have an opinion? Let me know down in the comments, but I think you can pull this off. So I'm just going to go with it. Point being is this sweater right here has the soft collar. It also has the buttons. This sweater is going to be a mid to, it's not super casual. I could actually wear this with a layer. I could actually even wear this maybe under a sports jacket, but it isn't going to be as formal as a crew neck or a V-neck sweater can be. Now with this sweater right here, there's probably two key characteristics that you pick up on. First up, we've got the half button. So you notice I've got the buttons here. And by the way, buttons are always going to be a bit more formal than zippers. Sorry, zippers are considered sport, but right here, as you can tell, it doesn't actually go halfway. Still, it's called a half button. Also, you'll notice the patterns. Basically, this pattern here makes the sweater much more casual. It also draws attention up to the chest area. So if you're a bigger guy and you want to draw attention to your chest, because let's say you're a little bit big in the midsection, this would be a great sweater that you could pull off. But understand that this sweater is casual. Would look great with jeans, works well maybe with, even chinos or a type of khaki, but it would never be something that you would wear with dress slacks or a suit. Now I mentioned that zippers are casual. So does that mean that you never buy a half zip? Of course not. Actually, I've got a number of these in my wardrobe. Just understand their limitations. This is going to be a casual style. You could maybe wear it with a sports jacket when you're traveling. I know I do, but I'm never going to wear it with a suit. It is just because of the zipper, never going to be anything that can go above the sports jacket level. But it looks great with this combination right here with dark jeans, or if I'm going to be traveling and I just want something to be able to throw on. So again, a look, and actually I like the functionality. It gets cold. Zip that right up. So a good functional piece. Next up, we've got the sweater vest. When it comes down to it, it's functional. It can be layered, and it's got a very interesting history. And it worked for Trestle over at Ohio State. So if you like it, own it, wear it, bring it into your wardrobe. Next up, we've got the cardigan sweater. Now, the one key characteristic that separates this sweater from all others is it's not a pullover. This one will actually have an opening in the front, either using buttons or a zipper. Two other things you'll probably see on a lot of cardigans, but it doesn't have to be there, is going to be pockets right in the front. And you'll also oftentimes see lapel. A lapel is basically where the sweater folds over like this, very similar to what we see on a jacket. Again, doesn't have to have these, but we're going to see a wide variety of different cardigans made from different materials, some of them being casual, some of them being lighter weight that actually could be layered under a jacket. So speaking of layering, how do you do it and look good? Guys, I've got you covered with this video right here, how to layer like a boss, 10 rules you need to follow when you're layering your clothing. So you want to take your sweater, add it to the other outfits in your wardrobe. I show you exactly how to do it in this video right here. Go check it out.